All right, Shay asked you guys how you're doing, and you did not make enough noise for me, so we're gonna have to try that again. So what do you guys say? Are you ready for a show? Yeah! Well, that was much better. Well, welcome to our California Sea Life Coliseum, sponsored by Bridgehampton National Bank. My name's Colleen, and I'll be the host of your show. And joining me up here in just a moment will be the star of your show. She goes by the name of Bunker. Bunker's one of our female California sea lions. She is 14 years old and weighs in about 180 pounds. And joining Bunker today will be our good friend and trainer, Nicole. Now you guys did a great job for me. It looks like some of you guys got the right idea. This is where all your applause really does count. So put your hands together and help me welcome your two stars. That's right, it's Nicole and Bunker. Now, if you see anything you like, anything at all, please don't be shy. Bunker here really does appreciate all of your applause. With a nice smile from your little feline friends. But before we continue, I think Bunker wants to say hello to her trainer this morning, so let's give them a moment. With a very nice professional flipper shake, very cute, you two. It does take a lot of trust and teamwork to work with a wild animal such as your star, Bunker. Now, we know here at the aquarium it can be difficult to tell the differences between California sea lions such as your star, Bunker, and her cousin, the true seal, such as our harbor and gray seals, which you may have seen are quite a good, or Calypso you may see swimming around in our exhibit. With Nicole and Bunker's help, we're going to go over some of those differences for you. The very first difference can be found in their necks. Sea lions have very long and very flexible necks. Nicole's going to use a target pull to stretch her neck all the way up there for you guys, which is pretty impressive. But just wait. Her neck is so long and so flexible. She could touch her nose all the way to her back. Check this out. Would you look at that flexibility? Now, her cousin, the true seal, has just a flexible neck. It's just not as long as the California sea lion. The next difference can be found in those front flippers. Sea lions have very small and very powerful front flippers right there. Now she uses her powerful front flippers to pull herself through the water while swimming, just like you or I use our arms. While her cousin the true seal uses their much shorter front flippers to steer themselves through the water, just giving you a great display of both birds. The next difference can be found in their ears. If you look at the side of Bunker's head, you'll see that she's an external ear pup. And she's going to come up nice and close where you can get a nice view of her. Now, Nicole is pointing out that external ear pup, just like you or I have. While her cousin, the true seal, has just a small opening behind each eye. And there's another view right there. Now, the next difference can be found in those rear flippers. Due to her rotating hip bone, Bunker has the ability to tuck her rear flippers up and underneath her body, which makes her very mobile out here on land. As you can see, she had no trouble at all jumping on and off her seat and following the full both backwards and forwards with ease. Now, her cousin, the true seal, lacks this rotating hip bone, and they tend to look a little silly out here on land, and Bunker has a great impression. So, Bunker, what does a true seal look like out here on land? That's right, like a great big fuzzy angel. I'm going to do it out for your star. She's acting awfully silly for us. But she is in fact correct. When a true seal comes out here on land, they scooch around their bellies with their rear flippers tucked out behind them. And the final difference we're going to be pointing out for you folks is down the noises that they make. Now, Bunker is very soft-spoken, so I'm going to hand the mic over to her and let her serenade you all. Grunting or snoring noise. But now that you know some of these differences, make sure to point them out for yourself and check out Bunker and our true seal exhibit a little bit closer today. But Bunker here is actually a double threat. Not only is she a wonderful singer, she's also an accomplished dancer. So what do you guys say? Do you want to see Bunker dance today? That's what we we thought that we got her favorite song. Now that you hear the tune, just clap along to help her keep the rhythm. All right, Spunker, take it away. Now these two ladies are not done showing off for you just yet, but they're going to make their way inside their exhibit and continue showing off for you in there. But while these ladies make their way around, let me tell you a little bit more about our California feline. Now as I said before, Bunker is very ladylike, 180 pounds. Now this is the perfect weight for a female California feline, since they usually max the scale about 250 pounds. In the front folding pool is Java. He is our one and only male California feline. He is 14 years old, just like your star Bunker, but he weighs in about 380 pounds. Now this may sound pretty large to your eye, but Java has been growing and still do, since male California felines can usually max the scale by 800 pounds. So he could more than double in size. In the back folding pool is Mila. You're going to see her in just a moment. She's about 2 years old and weighs in about 45 pounds. Now she's going to be coming out that exit over there, and she's going to have a little bit of a 5-minute segment. So when you see her, let's give her a nice big round of applause. Danielle's giving you all a nice big wave hello. Now, Neela has a pretty amazing story. She was a rescue from California. So about a year and a half ago, she was found along the west coast of the United States in California, in Santa Barbara. Now, she was found stranded, dehydrated, and starving. A massive stranding is happening in California, where a lot of mothers have to abandon their pups to search further for their food. Now, a rescue center did find Neela, and they made her nice and healthy and strong. However, she was declared as unreleasable because she wasn't fighting hard enough for her food. Now, felines are very social animals. They live in large groups called rookeries. So if Neela wasn't fighting hard enough for her food around other felines, they thought she wouldn't be a very good candidate to survive in the wild. So about a year ago, we were asked here at the Long Island Aquarium if we would like a brand new feline, and we said, of course. So a couple of our trainers went to California and brought her back here. So for about a year now, she has been working on some behaviors. Now, as you can see, that she knows how to do spin and give you a nice big wave. But we also focus on other behaviors, which is called husbandry behaviors. Now, this is a fancy word for medical behaviors. So Neela and all our other felines help us take care of them so we can keep them nice and healthy. So we cooperate with them on all their medical visits. Now, Neela is still getting used to large crowds here, so she comes out for about 5 minutes, but her segment is just about over. So let's give her a nice big round of applause. Now, all of our felines take turns throughout the day to perform in our shows. We like to keep them separated. This way, there's no competition for food or attention from their trainers. Now, Neela, Bunker, and Java all take turns. But right now, it is Bunker's turn, so we're going to welcome her back to her show. Let's give her a nice big round of applause. Here's Bunker for you. Now, as I've been saying throughout the show, Bunker is in fact a California feline, and this species can be found along the west coast of the United States, all the way south to the Baja Peninsula down in Mexico, to all the way north to British Columbia and Canada. And in the wild, they are found in large groups called rookeries. And in these rookeries, they need to be very quick, very agile, and very brave, not only in the water, but also right here on land. So Bunker is going to prove to you all just how brave she is by making her way to the highest point of her exhibit. And she's made it up there with no trouble at all. So Bunker, not one of your fans is very impressed with that climbing skill, but it's okay. You see, Bunker's actually so brave and so creative, she's not even afraid to high dive. Bunker! High dive! Your fans were just laughing at you. Are you feeling a little bit scared up there, Bunker? Oh, maybe if all your fans put their hands together and applaud for you, you'll be brave enough to show off your high dive tonight. All right, I hear your fans out there. Can we see your amazing high dive? She is our brave young star. She just needs some encouragement from our fans. Now, to end your show, we're going to answer a very popular question we get here at the Aquarium, which is, how do we train all the behaviors you've seen throughout the show? With Nicole and Bunker's help, we're going to answer this question for you. Now, the very first behavior an animal learns here at the Aquarium is called targeting. This simply means the animal learns to place their nose to our fist, which they're showing you right back there. Once the animal is comfortable targeting our fist, we can have them target other objects, such as that red and white buoy on a stick called a target bowl, or even that color of a ball spent high above the water. You see, once our animals are comfortable targeting these objects, we can have them follow it, and we can achieve really cool behaviors such as jumping. You see, that ball is right at the surface of the water, but over time, you're able to raise it higher and higher to the point it's at today. But, I don't know, you guys, that ball does look awfully high. I think she's gonna need some encouragement from her fans. So what do you guys say? Bunker, can you touch that ball? And remember, folks, that was all 180 pounds up and out of that water to touch that ball. And for doing such a great job with that behavior and all her others, her trainer Nicole rewards her with lots and lots of her favorite food, which is, of course, fish. Now, this is called positive reinforcement, and that is how we train all of our animals here at the Long Island Aquarium. But unfortunately, with that graceful jump, it does bring us to the end of our show. You guys have been such a great audience. Let's give it up for your two superstars one last time. Now, on behalf of myself, our sponsor, Bridgehand National Bank, and your two superstars, Nicole and Bunker, we thank you for coming here today, and we hope you enjoy the rest of your day here.